इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, अर्बनाइजेशन, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन। Actually, these are the causes of tribal problems. ठीक है ना? तो बताओ, तुम बताओ, हाउ दीज फोर थिंग्स आर रिलेटेड, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, अर्बनाइजेशन, डिस्प्लेसमेंट, रिहैबिलिटेशन। इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, अर्बनाइजेशन, यस, फिर हाउ रिहैबिलिटेशन इज लिंक्ड, यहां पे थोड़ा सा गड़बड़ कर रही है पिंकी। जहां तक डिस्प्लेसमेंट की बात है, सी इज करेक्ट। नाउ यू हैव टू लिंक ऑल दिस थ्री विथ फोर्थ वन, रिहैबिलिटेशन। Simply because of displacement, they lost job, home, so they must be compensated. And that's why rehabilitation. So, Kirti, do you think that when industrialization, urbanization, leading to large-scale displacement, it should be carried forward? Should industrialization and urbanization be carried forward because it results in large-scale displacement? What is your opinion? क्या बोलते हैं अभिनव, क्यों होनी चाहिए? Why it is need of the hour? नहीं नहीं मैं जस्ट, तुम जो चाहो कह सकते हो, मैं जस्ट सवाल कर रहा हूँ। सेवन बिलियन इंडिया में थोड़ी ना है। See, we are discussing Indian condition, situation. Yes, yes. नहीं, मैंने जो पूछा था सब जवाब मिल गया। अब एक्सटेंड कर रहे हैं चीजें। सी, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड अर्बनाइजेशन आर नीड ऑफ द आवर बिकॉज सी इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड अर्बनाइजेशन आर नीड ऑफ द आवर बिकॉज आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस वी डिड नॉट इनहेरिट industrialized and urbanized state, but at the same time there was growing population, hana, so to feed this growing population we must go for rapid pace of industrialization and urbanization, So we cannot say that these are not needed because it displaces people from their habitats. You cannot suggest that, okay, stop urbanization, industrialization. But that results in large-scale displacement. Displacement leads to homelessness, joblessness, increasing mortality, morbidity, and marginalization of displaced people. Because that is inevitable. So they should be compensated. We should not say that industrialization is not needed because tribals are affected. And you cannot say that tribals should not be given compensation because it is a national interest. Many people can say that because of national interest, tribals should sacrifice their life. There are many quarters thinking of this. And you know that is the reason that tribals are not given due compensation. Governments try to find out excuses. The tribals ko dena nahi. See, they are the part and parcel of Indian state. And state or nation state comprises every citizen, and look at tribals and their numbers. And not only tribals are displaced, rural people also displaced. There are many non-tribals. So if 20 crore people get affected, that means it's a huge problem. So they should be compensated. That should be the approach. And government should come out voluntarily. See, why people are not ready to give their land? Because compensation is not available. If compensation available, this is not adequate. At the cost of tribals, so-called nation is growing. Who are growing? Adani, Ambani, Tata Birla. They are earning billions of dollars. In their lifetime, how they will earn from an industrial unit? Billions. But what tribals and rural people are gaining from that? So we should have a balanced approach. That is, industrialization, urbanization must be needed. At the same time, tribals should not be ignored, or displaced people should not be ignored. They should be given due compensation. Okay. So that should be the approach. And we have already seen industrialization, urbanization, displacement, and rehabilitation are linked. If question on any topic is asked, like discuss the impact of industrialization and urbanization on tribal people, you write up to rehabilitation. If question comes like, give your views about proper rehabilitation measures, you should start with industrialization and urbanization. For what reason people will be given rehabilitation measures? Kis liye diya jayega? Displacement. Why they are being displaced? Industrialization, urbanization. So link all these four, give case studies relevantly. It can be mathematics. Samjha na? But one thing you should add. See, impact on tribal. Meant because of industrialization and urbanization, what changes have taken place among tribals? Sahi bol raha na? That is the meaning of impact. So that means, what was the tribal conditions before this? should it be written or not? So if you are not saying this was the conditions of tribal before industrialization and urbanization, then you cannot say these are the impact. So in the beginning, we should discuss what are the conditions of tribals, rural people, before displacement. Then you come the process of industrialization, urbanization. Then shortcomings of displacement. Actually, there are certain process, certain activities which displace rural people or tribal people. Rinku, can you tell me what are these factors responsible for displacement? There was a question in 20s, 2006 or 2003, that point out factors responsible for displacement. Just point out, don't explain. So, what are factors results in displacement? Industrialization and urbanization are one factor. Any other factor? So you just point out the factors responsible for displacement. Figure one is multi-purpose projects or mining and quarrying. Yes, declaring a patch as national forest, reserve forest, biosphere. Or we natural forest. Fear setting up of NTPCs, then laying down networks of road, rails, that also causes displacement. Na? So when the tailword is point out, list, give a list. So don't explain. If you are explaining, that means you are doing unnecessarily because the demand of the question is not explanation. Just name the factors. So urbanization and industrialization among these factors. So write down frame. I'll be giving a lot of case studies. See, your impacts are positive impacts. After that, you write case studies. So, industrialization, urbanization, displacements and rehabilitation. This is an important topic. There are many facts, studies. If you give all the facts with case studies, then it will be an excellent answer. But one thing, you have no scope to explain. Because only for 20 marks you are supposed to write. You can't explain, but you should write each and everything. सो वी हैव टू डिस्कस अर्लियर सोशियो इकोनॉमिक सिचुएशंस ऑफ ट्राइबल. बताओ अभय, व्हाट वाज द सी यू विल सी दैट ऑलमोस्ट एवरी फैसेट ऑफ लाइफ हैज बीन अफेक्टेड बाय इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड अर्बनाइजेशन. सो यू हैव टू गिव अर्लियर कंडीशंस ऑफ ऑल फ्रॉम मैरिज टू फैमिली किनशिप रिलीजियन पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम इकोनॉमिक सिस्टम ऑल दिस थिंग. सो स्टार्ट विथ मैरिज बिकॉज इट इज ऑल्सो अफेक्टेड बाई दिस प्रोसेस. Why we are discussing forest? No, we are discussing industrialization, urbanization. No. So, what was the earlier conditions in marriage, family, kinship? See, they practiced polygamy, monogamy. They practiced intertribal marriage. Sorry. They practiced marriage within the tribe, means tribal endogamy. And you know, if they practiced intertribal marriage, there would have been honor killing. It was so strict in tribal societies. They practiced cross cousin marriage, parallel cousin marriage. And you know, they spend many days like festivals in marriage. They spent money extravagantly. That was the situation in marriage. Their family was large family, extended in nature. Then their patriarchal family. And head of the family was very strict. His authority is final about his family. They maintain strong kinship ties. And you can say kinship was existence of tribal people because of technological backwardness. They are living in isolated areas. Geographically isolated. They did not have contact with outsiders. That's why they did not have access to advanced technologies. So that's why they maintained a strong kinship ties. So that technological backwardness can be compensated by stronger social network. And they practiced hunting, gathering, fishing, pastoralism, shifting cultivation. Even they practiced settled cultivation that was based on primitive techniques, primitive tools. And therefore, their economy was subsistence economy, no surplus. Land was not treated as wealth because they were always on move. They are not completely settled, they are permanently settled. If they held a piece of land for the time being, it was held in the name of community. It was held in the name of ancestors. So that means they practice community ownership. Their economy was non-monetized. They did not have ceremonial consumption. Their economic condition is like this. But one thing remember, they are not poor also. They are not economically well off. But they are not poor. It is not a paradox. It is not necessary that if you are not economically well off, you will be a poor. It is not like this. So they are not economically well off, but they are not poor. Politically, they had multi-centric authority system and acephalous political system. Leaders were respected, they were followed blindly. Tribal leaders, they were rural bred, charismatic, and traditional. Having no exposure to outside world, or least exposure to outside world, but they are well respected in the society. Religion, see, they had various forms of religion, like animism, animatism, totemism, fetishism, naturalism. I have discussed all these forms of religions in earlier class. They had belief in spirit, souls, ghost, bhoot, preet. So they are highly superstitious. Then they are preliterate. Means they did not have script. That's why they could not read and write. So they should not be called illiterate. They should be called preliterate. So they are preliterate. Don't write they are illiterate. So this was the situation before industrialization and urbanization. Now, what had happened in all these things after industrialization and urbanization? That is your question or discussion. So what I have discussed, it should be written in within 50 words. Possible hai ki nahi? So don't take more than 50 words because we have to write a lot of things. अभी तो शुरू हुआ है एंड टेल मी दिस अर्लियर कंडीशन शुड बी रिटेन ऑन नॉट अदर्स यू कैन नॉट से दैट दिस आर द चेंजेस दिस आर द इंपैक्ट्स देखो इन कॉलेज यूनिवर्सिटीज इफ देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन इंपैक्ट राइट इंपैक्ट डायरेक्टली बट नाउ टेल वर्ड विल डिटरमाइन that only impact cannot be adequate for your answer. Because tail word will be like discuss, analyze, critically analyze. So you have to write everything and anything related to this four. So you should know how to compress the facts. How to write facts without explanation. Our tendency is to explain. Lekin, while you are understanding the facts, you must explain and understand. But while you are writing these facts, don't explain. Because this question will be asked only for 20 marks, not more than 20 marks. So you are expected to write 300 words. At the most, at the max, 350. So we have to write everything in 350. And we have to write many case studies also. See how words are important for you. To be economical, be effective in choosing words. Effective in choosing words. Okay. Now we should discuss what is the need of industrialization and urbanization. See, industrialization and urbanization took place before independence, but that was not a large scale. And whatever industrialization and urbanization occurred, that was done by colonial regime to protect and promote their colonial interest, not for the welfare of Indian people, not for the benefit of Indians. But after independence of India, we started welfare government. एट द सेम टाइम देयर वाज ह्यूज पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ. सो टू फीड दिस ह्यूज पॉपुलेशन वी कैन नॉट रिलाई ऑन इंपोर्ट. हाउ लॉन्ग यू कैन सस्टेन दिस ह्यूज पॉपुलेशन बेस्ड ऑन इंपोर्ट गुड्स एंड आइटम्स. सो देयरफॉर टू फीड ग्रोइंग पॉपुलेशन we needed a rapid or faster pace of industrialization. We had set up multi-purpose projects, mining and quarrying units, national thermal power projects, then laying down roadwork, roadways, railways. And all these economic activities have created a lot of pollution also. So to control pollution, we had to declare certain patches of forest as reserve forest, which can protect endangered species of flora and fauna, which can expand forest region. And because of all these activities, you know, land was required. Because industrialization, urbanization cannot be done without land. And they should be done nearby resources. And all these resources are present, found in inaccessible areas. Like forest, along the coast, in hill terrains. And here, most of the people are tribal. In this context, there is a data that 80% of the total resource in India is located in 18% of total land area. 80% of total resources in the country is located in 18% of total land area in India. And 80% of total tribal population live in this 18% land area. 80% of total tribal population live in 18% land area of India. So, obviously, most of the displaced people will be tribal. See, there is a data about displacement of tribal people and non-tribals by L.K. Mahapatra. He studied displacement due to industrialization and urbanization in different parts of India, like Bihar, West Bengal, MP, all these areas. And here he came out with the facts that out of the total displaced persons, 40% belong to tribals, 20% are SCs. And 80% of these people are assetless. 40% ST, 20% SC. Those are displaced. And 80% of these ST and SC populations who are displaced, they are assetless. Assetless. Okay. सो सी मीन्स हाफ ऑफ द रिमेनिंग नॉन ट्राइबल्स, वही तो होगा हिसाब से. सो दैट मीन्स मोस्ट ऑफ द डिस्प्लेस्ड पीपुल आर ट्राइबल पीपुल बिकॉज दे हैव बीन लिविंग इन दिस रिसोर्स रिच रीजियन सिंस टाइम इमेमोरियल. एल के महापात्रा, ठीक है. सो हाउ दे बिकेम डिस्प्लेस्ड क्लियर. नाउ वी हैव टू सी व्हाट आर द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट. सी देयर आर मोस्ट मोस्टली इंपैक्ट्स आर नेगेटिव इन नेचर बट दैट देयर आर सम फ्यू पॉजिटिव इंपैक्ट्स एज वेल. नहीं, दिस आर रियली गुड. फर्स्ट वी शुड डिस्कस नेगेटिव इंपैक्ट्स एंड वी कैन स्टार्ट विथ इकोनॉमिक इंपैक्ट और इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सिक्वेंस. थिंक व्हेन सम पीपल आर व्हेन पीपल आर डिस्प्लेस्ड फ्रॉम देयर लैंड व्हाट दे लॉस. They become homeless, jobless, and because of homelessness and joblessness, they will be marginalized. And because of marginalization, there will be increasing mortality, morbidity, and those are surviving. Their conditions are not very good. See, they migrate from industrial areas or they migrate from their homes or areas where they have been living so far to urban areas, cities, metros like Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata. And these people are not skilled people. They do not have technical know-how. Even they are not highly literate or educated. So when they reach metros and cities, they join unorganized sectors as rickshaw puller, hawkers, then laborers in petty shops, and where they stay in cities, they live in slums. And you know, these slums are deprived of all basic amenities. It has nothing. No drinking water, electricity, it is illegally connected. No toilet facilities. So when people are living in these conditions, it is inhuman conditions. Because of these inhuman living conditions, there is increasing alcoholism, increasing criminal activities. These innocent tribal people, became complex, critical. So these are the changes in economic conditions. These are negative changes. Now come to other than economic conditions. See, as far as marriage is concerned, you know, 4% marriages are inter-tribal marriages, which could not be imagined when they had been living in villages और रूरल एरियाज, पुअर पर्सन, इंटर ट्राइबल मैरिज, बिकॉज पीपल फ्रॉम डिफरेंट ट्राइबल कम्युनिटीज लिविंग टूगेदर इन द सेम स्लम, दे आर वर्किंग एज लेबरर्स इन द सेम फैक्ट्रीज, सेम शॉप्स. So that has resulted in inter-tribal marriage. And it was reported that 4% tribal marriage was inter-tribal marriage. ठीक है? Because of living in cities where most of the people are Hindus, they have adopted many Hindu norms. Like they are also demanding for dowry. Earlier, they demanded for bride wealth. Bride wealth. What is bride wealth? That is, at the time of marriage, groom's family gives something in kind to bride's family as a compensation. But nowadays, they are asking for dowry, which is not a practice in tribal society. And the marriage has become simplified. They spend only few days because they are not free. They are busy persons. Today they are not spending 10 days, 15 days on the occasion of marriage. They complete this ceremony within a couple of days. And many younger tribals flouting the norms of marriage. They're flouting the norms of marriage. For example, inter-tribal marriage, marrying within same clan. Usually they are clan exogamous. Many younger tribal flouting norms of marriage, such as inter-tribal marriage, clan endogamy, they're marrying within the clan. So these are changes in the institution of marriage. Then, family. What are the impacts on the institution of family? See, they now live in a small family, usually nuclear families. And authority of elders in the family is threatened because younger generation, they are not dependent on parental property, or they are not dependent on parents. They're economically independent, working in factories, working as laborers. So with economic independence, they are weakening authority of elders. I mean, they don't listen to authority, means head, father. And they're practicing nuclear family. Earlier they did not practice nuclear family. They usually practice extended family. Now changes in the institution of kinship. See, kinship was idiom of existence of tribals. You have seen. Today, non-kins are more important than kins. Because in slum, in factory quarters, next door neighbors are not your relative. In times of need or crisis, who comes to help? It is your neighbor. And these neighbors are not kins. So today they have learned to live without kins. So kinship bond has become loosened. It has been weakened. देन इन द फील्ड ऑफ पॉलिटिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सी नो लॉन्गर ट्राइबल्स लिविंग इन अर्बन एरियाज इंडस्ट्रियल एरियाज फॉलो मल्टीसेंट्रिक अथॉरिटी सिस्टम एंड असेफलस पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम सी दे आर पार्ट ऑफ इंडियन स्टेट बट स्टिल देयर लीडर्स आर गाइडिंग देम टूडे ट्राइबल लीडर्स आर अर्बन ब्रेड वेस्टर्न एजुकेटेड बट दे डिड नॉट एंजॉय द रिस्पेक्ट द वे लीडर्स इन विलेज गॉट रिस्पेक्टेड बट दे बिहेव लाइक ट्रेडिशनल लीडर्स ड्यूरिंग इलेक्शन मेनी ट्राइबल लीडर्स कॉन्टेस्टिंग इलेक्शन एट लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली लेवल पार्लियामेंट यू नो दे डिमांड दे आस्क फॉर वोट ऑन द लाइन ऑफ क्लैन लिनिएज लाइक जनरल लीडर्स दे आर आस्किंग फॉर वोट ऑन द लाइन ऑफ कास्ट क्रीड सो इट इज अ ट्रेडिशनल बिहेवियर सो लीडर्स आर एजुकेटेड लीडर्स आर अर्बन ब्रेड दे आर वेल एक्सपोज्ड They are exposed to outside world, but they are behaving like traditional leaders. They are asking for vote on the line of clan, tribe, not on the developmental plank. So these are the negative changes. So almost all the changes are negative but some changes are positive also what are the positive changes see now the superstitious people became rational they have developed scientific temperament because they go to modern school They go to public school, convent school. So because of Western education, they have become less superstitious. Since they have been living in urban areas, industrial quarters, now more and more tribals are increasingly becoming part of mainstream. They're increasingly becoming part of mainstream India. And they have mainstream India. They are well exposed to the outside world. And that has widened their vision. So these are the positive changes. So if you look at the impacts, then negative changes outnumber positive changes. So therefore, when people are displaced, they should be compensated. But you know, there are many shortcomings in the rehabilitation measures. Before that, you know, we have to substantiate these changes due to industrialization and urbanization with some case studies. So in this regard, we can mention the case study of Ranchi University and Planning Commission. Collaboratively, they studied process of industrialization in Hatia belt in Ranchi. Hatia. Then we can also refer to case studies by LP Vidyarthi in Chotanagpur. Then case study of Dasgupta, case study of Haldar, एंड केस स्टडी ऑफ यूनेस्को। तो अकॉर्डिंग टू कोलैबोरेटिव स्टडी ऑफ रांची यूनिवर्सिटी एंड प्लानिंग कमीशन, व्हाट दे सजेस्टेड और व्हाट दे ऑब्जर्व, सी बिकॉज ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड अर्बनाइजेशन, हतिया वो कुछ पॉजिटिव नहीं, बहुत बड़ा इशू नहीं, शादी में खर्चा करने का नुकसान थोड़ी ना, और अच्छी बात हुई ना, पता ना खाना खिला दिया तो बुरा हो, पहले कर ही नहीं पता था ना, उस पैसे ज्यादा नहीं था, लेकिन खर्चा नहीं करता, दे स्पेंड 15 days 20 days, टाइम स्पेंड करता था, मिलजुल के करता, अभी टाइम नहीं है उनके पास, गाना बजाना चलता था, हतिया इंडस्ट्रियल बिल्ड, इट्स ए लार्ज बिल्ट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज इन रांची, सो दे ऑब्जर्व्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द ट्राइबल्स इन दिस एरियाज became displaced, and because of displacement some tribals stayed back in this Hatia zone and many of them migrated to other areas like Kolkata, Delhi, Mumbai because of better economic opportunities. Because in this Hatia industrial belt, tribals were hardly accommodated because they are not skilled people. They are not Western educated. But those have stayed back in their homeland because it was the homeland of tribal. You know, their condition has not been improved because of industrialization. It is expected that their condition shall be improved. Many of them are working as unskilled laborers, pretty vendors. They are women folk joined as housemaid, rickshaw pullers. So their economic condition has improved. They are earning more money. But the quality of economic life has degraded. Since when they were in villages, no industrialization was there. See, they did hardly any scope. They did have any scope to earn. So now there is increasing scope of earning. But quality of economic life has deteriorated. See, they are not rickshaw pullers. They are not working as maid. They are not working as pretty vendors. So this is the case study of Planning Commission in collaboration with Ranchi University. उनका case study वो लोग इनमें नहीं है। और बाहर जो गया उनका case study किया कि नहीं नहीं किया, इस context में तो नहीं है। बाहर में गया तो वही तो मैं तो बोला तो है, केस स्टडी नहीं है, लेकिन दोज हैव माइग्रेटेड टू अदर सिटीज, व्हाट दे आर डूइंग, यही वो भी वहां पे यही कर रहे हैं, एंड आई डिस्कस दैट पार्ट ऑफ इकोनॉमिक कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस। देन केस स्टडी ऑफ एलपी विद्यार्थी, ही सेड ही स्टडीड दैट very few tribals got employment opportunities in industrial units in Ranchi zone, but almost all of them are working as third grade and fourth grade employees. Not a single tribal is working as manager or technical persons, theek hai, And those are working in industrial units. They are living in industrial quarters. In quarters, their living condition is better. They are living in pakka houses. They have good sense of hygiene and sanitation. They are interacting with outsiders. They are taking part in festivals of Hindus, Christians, Muslims. But most of the tribals, they are living here, poor landless laborers. They are working as rickshaw pullers, pretty vendors, hawkers, and their economic condition has been improved. But economic life has degraded. The same observation. But he has also observed that these people, irrespective of their economic status in urban areas, industrial areas, are more and more becoming part of national mainstream. They are keenly aware of political situation. Those living in urban areas, they may be poor. Their economic condition has improved, but economic life degraded, but they are keenly aware of their life, political happenings, happenings in nation and international. So that is the observation of L.P. Vidyarthi. Now what is the observation of UNESCO? UNESCO has observed that these industrial units in Chotanagpur, they have been earning billions of dollars. But tribals have sacrificed. And they are earning at the cost of tribal people. So tribals have not been given their due share. They have been deprived. So dekho, what we have discussed as part of impacts of industrialization and urbanization on tribal, have you seen that these case studies are substantiating? That is the importance of case studies. What you have said, that should be evidenced. I think 3 case studies are enough. Kya likh payega itna? Aur bhi main de sakta. Notes mein hai. Lekin 3 hi likhna mushkil ho jayega. So while you are writing case studies, follow something. Who is doing case studies? You must write their name. Where case study is done, geographical area, and purpose of case study. At least these 3 things should be mentioned. If you are not writing the name, then geographical area, then case study will be meaningless. Ek to kisne kiya, kahan pe kiya, aur kya theme hai. So why tribals situation have worsened due to industrialization and urbanization? Because of shortcomings in rehabilitation measures. What are the shortcomings? See, all land acquisition for developmental projects are done by Land Acquisition Act 1894. And all the laws you see, these are Amendment Act. This is the mother law of land acquisition. According to this law, compensation should be given to those people who can produce land record at the time of compensation. कॉम्पेंसेशन शुड बी गिवेन टू दोज डिस्प्लेस्ड पर्सन्स हु कैन प्रोड्यूस लैंड रिकॉर्ड एट द टाइम ऑफ कॉम्पेंसेशन. इफ यू कैनॉट प्रोड्यूस लैंड रिकॉर्ड यू विल नॉट बी गिवेन कॉम्पेंसेशन. एंड एज यू नो दैट ट्राइबल्स डिड नॉट हैव इंडिविजुअल ओनरशिप, दे प्रैक्टिस्ड कम्युनिटी ओनरशिप, दैट्स व्हाई दे लैक्ड लैंड रिकॉर्ड. सो देयरफॉर यू नो दे आर नॉट गिवन कॉम्पेंसेशन एट ऑल बिकॉज दे डू नॉट प्रोड्यूस, दे कांट प्रोड्यूस लैंड रिकॉर्ड. सी लैंड रिकॉर्ड कैन बी डन इंडिविजुअली ओनली, इट कैन नॉट बी डन कम्युनिटी वाइज. ठीक है. सेकेंड, कॉम्पेंसेशन शुड बी गिवेन अकॉर्डिंग टू विशेस ऑफ द ऑफिशियल, इट शुड नॉट बी एट द मार्केट प्राइस. इट इज नॉट दैट कॉम्पेंसेशन शुड बी गिवेन एट मार्केट प्राइस. ओरिजिनल लैंड एक्विजिशन एक्ट से दिस, बट द लैंड एक्विजिशन एक्ट विच हैज बीन पास्ड रिसेंटली by Modi government, it has a provision of compensation at market price. But फिर usually what happen, land is given against land, but wasteland is usually given. Wasteland. See, tribal are losing irrigable land, fertile land, but they are given wasteland. It is of no use. Second, TK Singh formula. According to this formula, those displaced persons have lost their land, one of the family members will be given employment in that industrial unit. Yes. TK Singh formula says that one member of displaced family shall be given employment in the factory which has been built on their land. But you know, in 1986, TK Singh formula was scrapped. Khatam kar diya gaya. Yes. During the regime of Rajiv Gandhi. So that means no employment to members of displaced family. कुछ तो मिलेगा. देन सी, लैंड एक्विजिशन हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन फॉर 50 मोर इयर्स, मोर देन 50 इयर्स आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस, बट इंडिपेंडेंट इंडियन गवर्नमेंट हैज नॉट मेड नेशनल रिहैबिलिटेशन पॉलिसी. देर इज नो नेशनल रिहैबिलिटेशन पॉलिसी. सम स्टेट्स हैव state rehabilitation policies, but these are only in letter, not in spirit. Theek hai. According to L.K. Mohapatra, who has extensively studied problems of displacement, problems of rehabilitation, he observed that, see, when people are displaced due to industrialization, urbanization, and any other activities, it is not only those people who have lost their land, they are affected. Many people are indirectly dependent on that area. In villages, you know, hawkers have definite area to hawk. So when a village is displaced, these hawkers lost their job opportunities. So no rehabilitation program includes these affected people. They are also affected. See, those are directly affected, they are not given. And those are indirectly affected, how they can expect? Then ethically unko bhi to dena chahiye na. So unke liye koi provision hai nahi. So these are the shortcomings because of which developmental projects have affected displaced people adversely. And because of this, those have given their land, they have not improved their economic condition. Their life has not been improved. Because most of them are not compensated. So now, we should discuss what should be proper rehabilitation. Because the package of rehabilitation which is offered presently inadequate. If it is not a law, then why it is illegal? If it is law that you have to purchase someone's land at market price, then it is illegal. But in case of individual transaction, there is no legality. Because you'll never sell your land below market price. But when government acquires land for developmental projects, then it is whether there is any provision for taking land at market price or not. If not, then it is not illegal. If it is explicitly written that it should be market price, so you have to give market price. Otherwise, one can approach the court. अगर लिखा नहीं है तो गवर्नमेंट तो ऐसे ही देना नहीं चाहता. So what should be the rehabilitation, appropriate rehabilitation measures? In this regard, you can give suggestions of B.D. Sharma. Who is B.D. Sharma? He was an IAS officer and cadre of MP, former MP. His optional was most probably mathematics and anthropology. And you know that MP is a paradise of tribal people. So he seriously involved in tribal development. He worked with tribal people. He became very familiar with tribal problems. And he has right solution also. But you know, his approach was different from the approach of government. That's why he could not continue his service. He retired from the sea. He took voluntary retirement and resigned simply. Then he started NGOs and working in MPs. So his suggestion is valuable suggestions. I know he is respected by anthropological communities. So whatever he suggests, it is very, very serious, practical, and valuable. Government nahi sunta na. So wherever B.D. Sharma's suggestions you can come across, you give your own suggestion. कभी कभी लिखता है गिव योर व्यूज. सी, आर यू एक्सपर्ट? तो योर व्यूज डज नॉट मीन दैट यू शुड गिव योर ओन व्यूज. यू बोरो समवन्स व्यूज एंड टेल मी दैट आई एग्री टू दिस व्यूज. वो तो समझ में आ जाएगा. नहीं, देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग इफ यू सब्सक्राइब टू समवन्स व्यूज. व्हाट इज द रॉन्ग? एटलीस्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड थिंग्स. And if you do not understand, then you cannot subscribe. So what B.D. Sharma says? See, his first suggestion, tribals should be accommodated in the industrial units which are built on their land. How it is? For any industrial units, there is a formulatory period. See, you cannot build an industry overnightly. It takes time, 4-5 years. So during this formulatory period, deserving tribal candidates can be trained. They can be trained. 5 years, not less. So after training, you give them job in your factories. Tell me, is it impractical? We aisa nahi keh rahe, tum de do job. Those are deserving tribal candidate. They should be trained during formulatory period. Then once unit start, they can be given job. Second suggestion, tribal should be given compensation at market price. Market price pe compensation dena hai. And they should be given fertile land, not wasteland. And apart from compensation in terms of land, money, they should be given residential facilities, residential units in and around industrial units must be built, keeping in mind tribal milieu, how they like to live. And in this residential area, there should be schools, park for relaxation should be built. Park ho, school ho, and that too in tribal milieu. So, apart from land, money, you have to give houses also. Those industrial units do not produce satisfactory rehabilitation program, they should not be allowed. Means when you are asking for permission to set up industrial units, along with that you have to submit package of rehabilitation. If it is satisfactory, then that unit should be given the permission. So he said, if these provisions are followed in letter and spirit, tribals and anyone will give their land happily. Think you are giving money, fertile land, home with all facilities, job also. Who is not going to give? Today we are just snatching with the brute force. But if you give all these things to tribals, they'll happily, anybody is happily going to share. ठीक है? लगने दो, because they are earning billions of dollars. See, if a factory is set up, that is going to be for more than 100 years. In these 100 years, how much they will earn? So, what you are going to give tribals, that will be least before them. कितना खर्च होगा बताओ? अब hundreds of billions कमाओगे, उसमें 1 billion भी अगर देना पड़ता दो, why you will be growing at the cost of these innocent people? And if you say it is for national interest, are tribals not part of this nation? And see, 40% those have been displaced, they are tribals. So lakhs of people are affected. and you are not giving compensation, you are giving excuses only. And see, all these problems like extreme left extremism, Naxalism, can be rooted to this. So, humne kaun sa nation building ka kaam kar raha hai? Theek hai. So, now conclusion. What shall be the conclusion, Kunal? See, there should be a balance. That is, industrialization, urbanization must be there. At the same time, those are displaced, they should be given due compensation. Then only national interest will be fulfilled. So we should strike a balance between national interest and tribal interest. Means we cannot stop industrialization and urbanization. At the same time, we should not allow tribals to be deprived. Kya bolte? So whenever this kind of situation comes, take balanced approach. You should not support one at the cost of others. So, ye topic hogi. Theek. So, dekho, maine jo kaha, that should be written in 300 to 350 words. So, I have explained, you should not explain. I have given a structure, first, earlier conditions of tribal, then process of industrialization, urbanization, then impact. In impact, I have given negative impact, positive impact. In negative impact, there are points like economic consequences and other than economic consequences, including marriage, family, kinship, religion, political system, then positive one. Then come shortcomings in rehabilitation programs. Then appropriate rehabilitation package according to B.D. Sharma. Then conclusion. So if anything is asked, you write all these things. Just change context. ठीक है, ये टॉपिक खत्म. सो विद दिस 50% ऑफ ट्राइबल सिलेबस इज ओवर. नाउ ऑल टॉपिक्स आर स्मॉल स्मॉल टॉपिक्स. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सेफगार्ड्स, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल सेफगार्ड्स फॉर एससीज, एसटीज एंड ओबीसीज. फर्स्ट वी कैन डू कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल प्रोविजंस फॉर इस एससीज कौन है शेड्यूल कास्ट बताओ कौन शेड्यूल कास्ट है कौन नहीं जानता क्या कास्ट व्हिच अरे तो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल होगी है कौन है शेड्यूल कास्ट ये तो पहले बता किसको डिक्लेयर कर सकता है ऐसा तो नहीं ब्राह्मीन शुड बी डिक्लेयर्ड एज शेड्यूल कास्ट तले ओबीसी क्या है अभी तो पढ़ना सिस्टम चलता ही नहीं है अभी जाति सिस्टम चलता है वर्ण सिस्टम इज पास्ट सो व्हाट वी फॉलो दिस इज कॉल्ड जाति सिस्टम एंड टू अंडरस्टैंड कास्ट सिस्टम वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड टू मॉडल्स वन इज वर्ण मॉडल अनदर वन इज जाति मॉडल सो वर्ण एग्जिस्टेड बिफोर गुप्ता पीरियड And when and how jati system emerged, we don't have any facts. Kaise hua? Kabu? But it is written in the history that during Gupta period, jati system got consolidated. And koi bolta jati system aisa hai, is bakt hai, wo galat bolta hai, misguiding. Only what we know, that is, during Gupta period, वर्ण सिस्टम वॉज इक्लिप्स्ड एंड जाति सिस्टम गॉट कंसोलिडेटेड तो अभी जो हमारे हायरार्कीज जो है इट इज बेस्ड ऑन जाति सिस्टम बट वी रेफर टू वर्ण सिस्टम टू अंडरस्टैंड ए कॉम्प्लेक्स सिस्टम ऑफ जाति सो आई विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज वर्ण सिस्टम जाति सिस्टम बट नॉट नाउ सेक्शन ए में करेंगे अभी के लिए इतना इनफ है ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य शूद्र और आर्टिसन कास्ट और ओबीसी अनटचेबल दलित और इस डिजायर Higher caste, or Dija caste, means twice born caste. These are lower castes. सो दोज आर अनटचेबल्स एंगेज इन फिल द ऑक्यूपेशन दे आर कॉल्ड दलित यूजुअली दलित आर गिवन द स्टेटस ऑफ एससीज to write one frame, discuss constitutional safeguards, not provisions. Question बहुत frequently आता है. हर साल कोई ना कोई है. जिसमें भी आता है यहाँ से आते रहते हैं. Safeguards, discuss constitutional safeguards for this. Likho, frame likho. 5 minutes. इसको मैं कुछ डिस्कस ही नहीं की. सब लोग कुछ ना कुछ तो जानता ही है. और फ्रेम ही तो लिखने के लिए कह रहा हूँ. कुछ ना कुछ लिखने के लिए थोड़ी कह रहा हूँ. इसके लिए क्या देख रहा है? कुछ तो जीएस में ऐसा आया था, तो पढ़ के गया है नहीं. किसका सकल लिखे तुम आप? देखो, परफिस अगर पढ़ने के बाद ही लिखेगा, तो बहुत सारा चीज तो पढ़ाने उसके अंदर से भी आएगा. पर्सनल बैकग्राउंड में क्या लिखेंगे? थे कि क्यों इसी में चल जाएगा, इसी में हो जाएगा प्रॉब्लम सर्फेस। इसके लिए जिंदगी तो ये दोनों तो एक ही चीज़ है, छोट बहुत सुनो भविष्य तो लिखेगा ना, व्हाट आर द वेयर इज द सेफगार्ड, सेफगार्ड कहाँ लिखा है? तो लिखा ही नहीं, जिसके ऊपर सवाल है उसी को लिखा लिखा। इम्पैक्ट ऑन किसी सोशलीकरण की किस चीज की कोई कनेक्शन तो है दिखे, बताना कैसे कनेक्शन तुमने सेव कर कहाँ लिखा? तो मेजर्स टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट, इसमें क्या लिखा है? चलो सजेशन किस चीज की, तब तक इसकी जो इवैल्यूएशन नहीं होगी साइजन कैसे देंगे? पहले साइजन से पहले इवैल्यूएशन होना चाहिए ना, तो यहाँ से यहाँ तक ठीक है। ये जो थोड़ा सा कंफ्यूजन वो सजेशन नहीं है, सॉरी इवैल्यूएशन नहीं किया, सजेशन कैसे देंगे? क्या कॉन्फ्रेंस है वही लिख के छोड़ दी, तो दसवीं में भी ऐसे लोग लिखते हैं, वो थोड़ा बहुत सोचता है तो क्यों सेफ गार्ड दिया गया। ये जो सेफ गार्ड दिया गया डिड इट अचीव इट्स रिजल्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव, भी नहीं दिया। अगर ऑब्जेक्टिव अचीव नहीं किया तो क्या सजेशन देना चाहिए? ऐसे अगर लिखेगा तो दस में तो दो से ज्यादा नहीं मिले, तुमने कुछ लिखा ही नहीं उतना तो सभी लोग जानते हैं। सेफ गार्ड पूछा तो सेफ गार्ड लिख दिया, कास्ट इंक्लूडेड अंडर दिस प्रॉब्लम सेफ गार्ड। देखो प्रॉब्लम्स फेस बाय देम फिर कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस कैसे, प्रॉब्लम्स आर देमसेल्व्स कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस, तो सिर्फ प्रॉब्लम लिखना फिर सिर्फ कर सीखना। हैज दिस सिर्फ कर बेनिफिटेड, तो इवैल्यूएशन की बात है तो शॉर्ट कमिंग दोबारा नहीं लिखनी। जब इवैल्यूएशन करती है तब उसमें गुड बैड दोनों मिल जाते हैं, फिर जो बैड थिंग्स है दैट शुड बी रिमूव्ड बाय सजेशन, इसमें ये चीज लिखना है। शॉर्ट कम दिख देना ठीक है, इसको हटा देना बाकी ठीक है। ये जिसने लिखा काफी सही लिखा लेकिन लास्ट में जाके डिलीवरेंस नहीं होती, तो गवर्नमेंट कोई स्टेप्स लेता है ना उसे इवेल्युएट करना पड़ता है। हाउ दिस सेफगार्ड्स आर वर्किंग, सही और सही नहीं, सो इफ दे आर नॉट वर्किंग करेक्टली सो मेक देम करेक्ट बाई गिविंग सजेशन। इस केस में रिलीवेंस ना लिख के राइट इवैल्यूएशन। मीनिंग ऑफ डिफाइंड ऑफ इस चीज डिफाइन करने की जरूरत नहीं है, उसमें लिखना इसी पॉपुलेशन क्या है, इस चीज़ को कहाँ कहाँ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड है, then you can see the magnitude of this people. The origin of historical basis of life. इन दोनों को हटा देना, उसमें लिखना प्रॉब्लम्स और सोशियो इकोनॉमिक डिसेबिलिटीज फेस्ड बाय दिस. एक्चुअली बिकॉज ऑफ दिस डिसेबिलिटीज गवर्नमेंट हैज गिवन, दैट इज द रीजन ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अच्छा, एक तो रिपीट है, जैसे सोशियो इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन, देन फैक्टर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन डिप्राइवेशन, दोनों एक ही चीज. फिर सजेशन दिया किस चीज की, सजेशन लिबरेशन कहा, तो सोच समझ के देगा ना. सजेशन किस चीज की देता है, हम ऐसे दे देते क्या, ऐसे रास्ते में लोगों को पकड़ कर पकड़ सजेशन देता है लोग, कुछ तो चीजें दिखेगा ना, वो बताया नहीं कैसे सेशन दे. ये किसने लिखा है, वेयर आर सेफगार्ड्स, कहां लिखा है, स्टेप्स टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट. तो जब क्वेश्चन इज ऑन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल सेफगार्ड्स, तो राइट सेफगार्ड्स लिखा चश्मा है नहीं बस इम्प्लीमेंटेशन. वेरी सजेशन, तो मतलब इफ देयर इज शॉर्टकमिंग्स दैट शुड बी रिमूव ना, तो सजेशन ऑटोमेटिकली कम्स. सो इफ यू आर इवेल्यूएटिंग इट मस्ट बी फॉलोड बाय सजेशन, क्योंकि इवेल्यूएशन में यू कैन नॉट सी एवरीथिंग इज राइट. सो इफ यू आर नॉट गिविंग सजेशन देन यू आर बिकम ए भक्त, भक्त को इवेल्यूएट नहीं करते, सिर्फ बोलो तो ऐसे कर दिया वक्त लग मान लेंगे, तो वक्त नहीं चलेगा. दिखाओ सेफगार्ड कहाँ है, अरे जो तुमने कैटेगराइज किया ना ब्रिटिश के दौरान किया था, आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस किया था, सबको एक साथ सेव कर कहाँ लिखा, तो जिसमें सवाल वो तो लिखेगा ना, वो तो लिखना ही चाहिए, किसी को नहीं लिखा, किसी लिखा ही नहीं. यू गॉट द क्वेश्चन ना, तब क्यों नहीं लिखा, थोड़ा लिखा दिखाओ. छोटा लिखा मुझे बस की बात, सही तो लिखा था, सजेशन का लिखा. याद रखना हमेशा, अगर इवेल्यूएशन देगा, इफ यू इवेल्यूएटिंग समथिंग यू मस्ट गिव सजेशन, रूल बना देता है. और बिना इवेल्यूएशन के सजेशन भी नहीं होती, एक रूल है. कभी कभी क्वेश्चन इवेल्यूएट समथिंग, क्वेश्चन में सजेशन तो पूछा नहीं, तो इफ यू आर नॉट राइटिंग सजेशन तो मतलब इवेल्यूएशन इज इनकम्प्लीट. व्हाई डू वी इवेल्युएट, इट इज नॉट टू फाइंड आउट गुड थिंग्स ओनली, टू फाइंड आउट शॉर्टकमिंग सो दैट दे कैन बी रिमूव्ड एंड थिंग्स कैन बी स्ट्रेंथन. समझा ना, लिखो फ्रेम लिखो. ये क्वेश्चन शायद तुम लोगों के लिए आज है, क्योंकि इस साल, और ये नहीं लिखा रिंकू, तो जो भी लिखा दिखाना चाहिए ना, खुद ही लिखा, खुद ही इवेल्युएट कर लिया, खुद ही सजेशन अपने आप को दे दिया. सही है, सेल्फ इवेल्युएशन. ये क्वेश्चन देखना, पिछले साल आया शायद, इस साल चांसेस कम है, रिपीट भी हो सकता है, नहीं तो तुम लोगों के टाइम शुरू हो गया। फोर्टीन में आया था, उसके बाद नहीं एस टी आया होगा। नहीं तुम, तुम्हारे पास क्वेश्चन है 16 तक, 15 तक है ना, 16 में शायद आया है जहां तक मुझे लगता है। जुडिशियल क्या है, समझ नहीं पाता क्या बोल रहा। नहीं, यही तीन सेफगार्ड्स, पॉलिटिकल, डेवलपमेंटल, प्रोटेक्टिव, जो भी प्रोविजंस है इसी तीनों में आएगा। शेड्यूल कास्ट पॉपुलेशन, शेड्यूल कास्ट आर ऑल्सो नोन एज अनटचेबल कास्ट, दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज दलित, दे बिलोंग टू द लोएस्ट रंग ऑफ हिंदू सोशल हायरार्की। लोएस्ट रंग ऑफ हिंदू सोशल हायरार्की, दे आर एंगेज्ड इन मिनियल और फिल्दी ऑक्यूपेशंस लाइक स्कैवेंजिंग, कॉबलिंग, लेदरिंग, ऑल दीज थिंग्स मीन्स मिनियल एक्टिविटीज, एंड दैट इज वाई दे आर कॉल्ड अनटचेबल्स, दे आर इम्प्योर कास्ट. ठीक है, दे कॉन्स्टिट्यूट 16% पॉपुलेशन ऑफ आवर कंट्री, 16 point something, सो दे कॉन्स्टिट्यूट अराउंड 16% ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इन आवर कंट्री. सो यू कैन इमेजिन वॉट विल बी द एब्सोल्यूट नंबर, इट इज अराउंड 20+ crore. एंड यू नो because of menial occupations, almost all are landless laborers and suffering from acute poverty. The largest number of SC population found in UP, largest. In northeastern states, there are few SC population, handful. UP, Bihar, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh constitute more than 50% SC population in the country. UP, Bihar, West Bengal, फिर आंध्र प्रदेश. ठीक, एपी 50% ऑफ एससी पॉपुलेशन. देन इन टर्म्स ऑफ परसेंटेज, पंजाब हैज द हाईएस्ट परसेंटेज ऑफ एससी पॉपुलेशन बिकॉज 6 also have SCs. So many of Sikh religion belong to SC category. And yes, ये सरदार लोग देखते हैं ना, इनमें काफी लोग SCs होते हैं. हाँ, SCs ज्यादा है बिकॉज दो सिखिज्म. हाँ, तो जो सिखिज्म जो है, इट इज एन एमलगमेशन ऑफ हिंदूज एंड मुस्लिम्स. एंड हु जॉइन सिखिज्म? दोज वेयर अनटचेबल कास्ट टू अवॉइड द स्टिग्मा ऑफ अनटचेबिलिटी. एंड दोज वेयर हायर कास्ट हिंदूज, दे हैड बीन लीडिंग दिस रिलीजन. जैसे 10 Sikh gurus, they belong to Jat Sikhs, है ना? So Khatris, लेकिन Jat भी होते हैं, Jat Sikhs भी होते हैं. So many Jats are higher caste Sikhs and many Jats are OBCs also. Jat में OBCs है, जो Jat Sikh जो है उनमें OBCs है, क्योंकि मैं जानता हूँ. नहीं नहीं, जो जट सिख है, हाँ वो भी अपने आपको जट बोलते हैं. लेकिन मेरा एक जानकार है, वो तो बोलता है हम जट है, लेकिन उनका जो कास्ट है कारपेंटर की कास्ट है. हाँ, रामगढ़ी है, लोग ओबीसीज में आते हैं. लेकिन देखो, मुझे बुकिस में तो पता नहीं है, लेकिन वो खुद बोला था, इसलिए मैं कह रहा हूँ. जो जाट जो है ना, जाट सिख जो दे आर जमींदार. लेकिन वो बोलता जो हम भी जाट हैं, तो इसीलिए मैं कह रहा हूं. तो देखो जो परसेंटेज एससी परसेंटेज है दैट इज अराउंड 33% इन पंजाब, 33% पीपल आर एससीज, इट इज द हाईएस्ट परसेंटेज इन एनी स्टेट. इन यूटीज इट इज दिल्ली विच हैज द हाईएस्ट परसेंटेज ऑफ एससी, इट इज अराउंड 20%. यहाँ पे तो एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी भी है, रिजर्व कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी, एंड दिस इज द राजेंद्र नगर, इट कम्स अंडर करोलबाग कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी. जो करोलबाग कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी जो है इट इज ए रिजर्व कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी, एंड यहाँ से जो भी जीतता है बीजेपी हो कांग्रेस हो एससी होगी. मीरा कुमार यहीं से जीते थे, ठीक है. इसके अंदर आता है तुम्हारा पूरा देगरपुरा, करोलबाग, ये सारे एससी लोग हैं, ठीक है. सो दिस इज द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ एससी पॉपुलेशन. सो सोशियो इकोनॉमिक डिसेबिलिटीज, सी सिंस दे आर अनटचेबल कास्ट, दे आर पुअर पीपुल, दे फेस मेनी डिसेबिलिटीज, सोशल डिसेबिलिटीज, एजुकेशनल डिसेबिलिटीज, इकोनॉमिक डिसेबिलिटीज, पॉलिटिकल डिसेबिलिटीज, एंड यू नो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस दे हैव बीन गिवेन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल सेफगार्ड्स सो दैट देयर सोशल कंडीशंस, इकोनॉमिक कंडीशंस कैन बी इम्प्रूव एंड दे कैन बी मेनस्ट्रीम, ठीक है. सो व्हाट वर द डिसेबिलिटीज, एंड दीज आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अनटचेबिलिटी. सी एस सी पीपुल वर नॉट अलाउड टू एंटर इन टू टेम्पल्स, दे आर नॉट अलाउड टू एंटर इन टू पब्लिक प्लेसेस लाइक शॉप्स, वेल, प्लेस ऑफ एंटरटेनमेंट, दे आर नॉट अलाउड. यू कैन से वट इज द यूज ऑफ गोइंग टू टेम्पल्स, ऐसे भी तो कुछ रखा नहीं. एक्चुअली टेम्पल्स were traditionally centers of learning. So if you are not allowed to enter into temples, you are not allowed to have access to education. See, if you are not allowed to interact with members of higher caste, actually you are deprived of having access to knowledge. See, people of higher caste were educated. They are learned. They are men of wise. So if they are not interacting, or SCs are not allowed to interact with higher caste, how they can be knowledgeable? Because they are not allowed to take part in education. Traditionally, they cannot participate in education. So they are not able to participate in education. They are not allowed to interact with higher caste. So they remain uneducated. Generation after generation. Even today, there are many places in our country where SCs are still disallowed to enter into school. And there are separate places in the school premises for sitting of SC students. Last year, one case came into light in Rajasthan. One SC student of 5th standard or 6th standard, he shared water from his teacher's water bottle. He was beaten up with canes. So pita gaya tha. How being a member of SC, you can touch my water bottle, you can take water from my bottle. So this is still practiced in our country. Now in schools, today cannot be denied, but in schools there will be different containers for SC students for drinking water. So discrimination is still going on, but in the past there was complete discrimination. So these are social disabilities and educational disabilities. That means they are not learned persons. Think how one can improve in life without knowledge, without लर्निंग, देन इकोनॉमिक कंडीशंस, एससीज वेर नॉट अलाउड टू होल्ड लैंड एज प्रॉपर्टी एंड देयर आर लोकल रूल्स व्हिच प्रोहिबिट्स, फॉर एग्जांपल दारुल अमल, इट्स ए पंचायत रूल इन गढ़वाल रीजन दैट कोल्टा एन एससी पॉपुलेशन दे कैनॉट होल्ड लैंड, इट इज प्रोहिबिटेड बाय लोकल पंचायत. दारुल अमल, दिस इज ए लोकल रूल, दिस रूल प्रोहिबिट्स कोल्टा फ्रॉम होल्डिंग लैंड. एससीज आर नॉट अलाउड टू होल्ड गोल्ड ऑल्सो, गोल्ड भी होल्ड नहीं कर सकते. सी नाउ इफ ए कम्युनिटी कैनॉट होल्ड लैंड, कैनॉट होल्ड गोल्ड, हाउ दे कैन प्रॉस्पर इकोनॉमिकली? So it has been imposed on them from generations. And SCs have no right to make decision for society. So decisions are made by higher caste. And that is imposed on them without their participation. Think you cannot make decision. You cannot hold gold, land. You have no interaction with so-called higher caste. You have no right to education. How a community can prosper in life? And moreover, SCs have been dehumanized by Hindu religion. See, in South India, in Travancore district, SCs could only enter into marketplace, that is a public place, during noon. Because during noon, the shadow is the shortest one. It is practiced there, if shadow of SCs fall on houses of higher caste, their houses will be polluted. So mere shadow of SCs pollute the houses of higher caste. So that's why they are allowed to enter into public places like marketplace, any other thing, during afternoon and morning. Sorry, during only noon time. No allow during afternoon. They are not allowed during morning because this time shadow becomes longer. In Maharashtra, Mahar was treated as Chandal. Mahar is a SC caste. Ambedkar belongs to that caste. You know, whenever they enter into public places, they had to declare their arrival by beating drum, hanging from neck. Socho. That was the treatment meted out to SC population. Maharashtra. So this is called untouchability. So a section around 20 crores population, dehumanized, no right to education, no right to wealth, means in traditional society, land, gold are considered to be wealth. They cannot hold, and no right to decision making. Think how they can grow and how they can thrive in their life. So if state does not come forward, if state does not support them, can they be mainstreamed? Means can they be integrated with general population? See, what is the, you may think, what is the use of bringing SC population to general population? See, if they are isolated, if they are not supported by state, their conditions will be worsened. And they will be further isolated. And if 20 crore populations are isolated further because of these deprivations, continued deprivation and discrimination, do you think this country can continue as an intact India? See, if communal pact in 1932 was not accepted, then there could have been another partition like Pakistan and India. See, the genesis of reservation can be traced to communal award. There was an agreement between Gandhi and Ambedkar that you support our cause. Otherwise, another faction can grow. So think, if that pact was not reached, what could have happened? So the goal of India is to make a nation. And what is nation? Sense of oneness, sense of belongingness. Think, if a community of 20 crore are deprived, isolated, can they ever feel they're part of this state? They're part of this country? So if you want to make India, they must be supported so that they can be integrated to mainstream population. And that's why reservation is given. That's why this safeguards. So reservation may harm individual interest, but it is for a greater cause. That is public interest and national interest. Surely it affects individual. But think, individual interest should prevail or national interest should prevail? Do you want to make India further divided? Or do you want to have our India much stronger, much united? And for that, you have seen tribals should be supported. SC should be supported. If they are deprived, tribals are isolated. If you want to bring them to national mainstream, they should be supported. See, if they are not... If they're allowed to live on their own, tribal school, if state is allowing them to live on their own, no support from the state, what will happen? They will be further isolated. They will be further exploited. And do you think they will sit idle? See, I'm not saying any extreme statement. See, when they're educated, they know their problems. If government is not supporting, there is proliferation of mass weapons, and that is breeding movements like left extremism, Naxalism. Don't you think this can be precursor to the division of India? If they are not tackled in the beginning. So, even after giving reservation, they are not treated well. You don't think that reservation is coming easily. See, there are backlogs of SCs and ST in central government. You know, in UPSC, 18,000 backlogs are there for SCs. And particularly UPSC exam. 18,000 backlog, why in SC? But only few hundreds are backlog in general category. So even this state is not ready to give their due share. And by doing so, you are lengthening the problems. 50 years har saal har baar extend hota jayega. Solve kuch bhi nahi ho raha. So we'll see the shortcomings of this safeguards. एंड व्हाट शुड बी डन दैट कैन बी सीन इन द सजेशन. सो रिजर्वेशन इज वन ऑफ द सेफगार्ड्स. इट हर्ट्स इंडिविजुअल इंटरेस्ट बट इट प्रमोट्स नेशनल इंटरेस्ट. इफ यू वांट टू कीप इंडिया इंटैक्ट इन द लॉन्ग रन देन रिजर्वेशन इज वेलकम. So those are opposing to the reservation policy. You know, they are not actually appreciating the real reason of reservation. They are always focusing on individual interest. And state is supposed to promote public interest, group interest. So individual suffer karte hain. Lekin if reservation is not given, the state will suffer. So never oppose reservation policy. It is a need of our. But surely this policy should be reviewed. There are many loopholes. So unless and until these loopholes are plugged, the goal of reservation policy will never be achieved. So you should not oppose that reservation policy should not be reviewed. It should be reviewed. So two things you should remember: never oppose reservation policy and never oppose reviewing reservation policies. It should be reviewed. And it should be reviewed from time to time. ऐसा नहीं अभी 50 साल हो गया अभी तक रिव्यू नहीं हुई है. अगर इस साल होते 10 साल बाद फिर रिव्यू करो. So that ultimate problem of extending reservation policy should come to an end. How long this state can go with reservation? इससे किसी का भला नहीं हो रहा. कुछ individuals are becoming elite. ठीक है ना. तो ये दोनों चीज याद रखना. इंटरव्यू में हो सके पूछ ले तो कभी अपोज नहीं करना. पॉलिसी को अपोज नहीं करना जरूरी है. अभी भी जरूरत है क्योंकि दिस 16% population still most of them are deprived and discriminated. क्योंकि इतने कुछ सेफगार्ड्स के बावजूद भी डोंट थिंक देयर कंडीशंस हैव बीन इंप्रूव. नहीं इंप्रूव हुई है. कुछ लोग फायदा ले लिया. तो कल करेंगे. ये टॉपिक जीएस के लिए